Okay, it's been quite some time since I gave you a bit of UAE based updates. As you know that after my wife left and, you know, December, I overworked myself to the point of utter exhaustion and I decided to take a break. And then my wife had to leave for her father's funeral and then the house was a mess. So I decided I would focus on this project and take my mind off the UAE based updates. That's why if you actually look at it, there's hardly any UAE based news. I didn't post anything, hardly one or two. Before I used to post almost every day. The reason being is I wanted to focus on the task at hand and I wanted to give myself a mental break. Even clients this month, absolutely no clients. I didn't bother, I didn't. If someone came, okay, fine, they came. I didn't push for it. I was mainly focused on servicing the old clients. And the main thing was my house. You'll see a video very soon of me completing the house. Trust me, it was fucking too much, man. Too much. Each and everything to keep in place. Wife's things, baby's things, my things. Kitchenware, you know, utensils, buying new stuff, sorting out things, keeping in place, throwing things out. Oof. It's you'll be surprised to know it's going to take me another 2 weeks to actually finish it. So it has literally taken me a month, one full month to sort out, clean my house and keep things in place. So anyway, my main thing which I want to tell you is After January, I'm going to go back to old schedule. That's going to be focus on Dubai based updates. It's going to be focused on market terms. Hi doggy. Hey, nice doggy. They're busy. I'll focus on market based updates. Job stuff. Resume rebrand, personal branding, and yes, back to clients. You know, clients will come on board. Let me see what, if I can think of a, like getting back into the groove of something like that. I'm not too sure. So yeah, that's going to be for January. That's the update. Feb onwards is going to be back to UAE updates, resume rebrand, job hunts. That's why I've not posted anything now. One thing which I just want to tell you is, you know, like I spoke to this client yesterday, guy, he has just come to Dubai. I mean, he came to Dubai and now he's on looking out for a job. He took my services and I asked him, like, what are you looking at? Yeah, I'm looking at, you know, he gave me two or three totally different genres. Like, he's telling me finance or HR or sales and marketing, you know, or project management. I said, wait, how can you focus on all this? He's saying, I'm looking at anything. I said, how can you look for anything? Then I asked him, okay, what was your strategy before coming to UAE? He said, what do you mean by strategy? I said, so you didn't have any strategy? He's saying, I didn't understand. I said, you just came to UAE just to look out for a job? He said, yeah, I just came to UAE. Now, he's a guy, he's in his 40s. He has just come to UAE without even thinking, without even, how can you do that, man? So I asked him, okay, where are you from? He told me he's from Delhi. So I gave him the example. I told him, what if I came to Delhi and I just arrive in Delhi and I call you up and I say, I want to get married. And if you ask me, okay, who did you come to meet? No, nobody. I just came here to get married, to find a girl. Where can I find a girl? What would your reaction be? He said, that would be stupid. How can you just come and I want to find a girl to get married? I said, yeah, that's equally the same. How can you just come to UAE and just say, okay, I want a job, any salary? You can't, I don't know how people don't use their common sense. And then he said, okay, this is my CV. I said, your CV focuses on a particular path, a particular career. He said, can I use this CV for another? How can you use, for example, the sales and marketing CV, how can you use it for a let's say HR or sales and marketing? He's saying, okay, can you change and make it universal? See guys, this is not the way to look for a job in UAE. This is not the way to... See, just like, you know, the example I give, I go to a place and say, okay, I want to marry someone. People will look at and think, are you fucking mad? How can you just marry someone? You need to know who you're looking at. You need to know what you want. You need to register on sites or whatever, meet some, chat with some girls, get to know them, have an appointment. You know, same even a job. You can't just turn up on the doorstep and, okay, I'm looking for a job. And as it is, I've always told people that there are already people unemployed who are looking out for jobs who are in the country. Like this one other female, she had booked my services. And she said, okay, I took your services, help me get a job. I said, you took my services to get a job. She said, I don't provide jobs. I can tell you what is wrong on your CV or what is wrong with your interview skills or what is wrong with your strategy and how you can change it. So she said, okay, what is it? I pointed all the mistakes. And after she took down notes and then she said, okay, now what about my job? I said, what do you mean, what about my job? I never promised you a job. He's saying, then what is the use of coming to you? Yeah, you don't do your fucking homework. You just turn up in UAE and you expect that I'm a miracle worker. Or you paid me $197. Okay, Loy will give me a job. I don't know from where people get this idea that, okay, I paid him $197. I'll get a job or my problems will be solved. There are no miracle workers. There is no such thing as jobs for cash. I don't know who gives them this message. I've been very explicit about it. One last thing which I want to tell you is this, whatever is coming in the news, no? Whatever you're reading in the news, I've told you this before and I'm telling you now again. Today, the news platforms are biased towards a particular angle. Okay? Now, for example, before Expo 2020 comes, you're going to see a lot of wonderful hype news, a lot of good stuff about UAE. UAE is booming. Money is coming in. Projects are successful. Why? It's a pre-marketing requisite for Expo 2020. Okay? For example, CNN does not like Donald Trump. Okay, they prefer Democrats. Then you'll get maybe I think that Fox News or something, they support Republicans. Even in India, you have some news channels which support Modi and some news channels which are anti-Modi. Even in Pakistan, you have news channels which support Imran Khan and ones that go against him. So the point I'm trying to make you understand is when you read any news, use a little bit of your mind and think. And why do I bring this up is because people keep sending me these messages. Loy, this is what is said in the news. Oh, the market is improving. Jobs have come in. No, you need to do a little bit of thinking, a little bit of research. And I'm telling you again, please don't apply through Nadia's, Gulf Talent, Gulf Jobs. It's a total waste of time. I can guarantee you this much. You'll not get any job offer. You'll not get any acknowledgement. You'll just get a standard CV, a standard email. Oh, we have received your CV. We are looking into it. Or they'll try to upsell you a service of theirs. There are no jobs. Trust me when I say this. It's common sense. There are no jobs that are being offered. One last thing is, please be careful what kind of news you share, especially in relation to COVID-19. Yes, there are there will be news articles, okay, this person's face got paralyzed, this person had breathing difficulties, this person got allergy with the medicine. But you're talking in large numbers. Like for example, seafood, if I eat crab or I eat shells, crab or prawns, if I eat lobster, crab, prawns, I get a very severe allergy, very severe, to the point I've been hospitalized. Now, does that mean crab and prawns and this thing are poisonous? No. Does that mean if you eat crabs and prawns, you'll have the same reaction? No. My wife eats, nothing happens to her. She eats, sometimes eat raw prawns and raw crab. Nothing happens. But for me, even cooked, well cooked, I have a very severe reaction to the point where I was almost going to die. So, just use a little bit of common sense. And as far as I've told you, people have still asked me, should I take the vaccine or should I not take? I told you, if it is me, I'll wait for some time, as long as I can, 2 years, until I see what are the reactions and how people react, or, you know, maybe there's an improvement in the process. With regards to what India is doing, that's totally scary, because without any trial or tests, they're just giving that India-made vaccine. I just feel there's a lot of under-the-table activities for that. It's very suspicious that you don't want to take an international product, you want to take a local product which has not been verified. So I would say, don't be an anti-vaxxer. It's, you must take a vaccine. But I would only say, be a little patient. But more important than the vaccine, follow preventive measures. Do exercise, keep good health, and follow rules of the country. Don't reinvent your rules, and don't be an expert thanks to WhatsApp or Google or whatever conspiracy theories people give. So this is what I wanted to share with you. And in a nutshell, get ready for Feb, for the month of Feb. I'm going to be back to normal, and things are going to be like before. All right. So you guys take care. Thanks for watching. See ya.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying, or by magic, through others, or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.